Greetings and welcome back to some more Battletech. Before we jump into the flashpoint, I just wanted to give a quick overview of the two lower difficulty grinding missions that I'm doing off camera. So basically, I'm just showing you the end screens for both of these. So this one was the ambush convoy. So we had a convoy of four enemy vehicles, one of them a demolisher tank with two AC-20s. That kind of hurt a little bit. And there were two Hatchetmen and a Shadowhawk in the opposition. So this is the outcome of that mission. I also decided to take Voodoo and Dragon on the mission, just to get some XP on the pilots that don't see action all that often. Then again, Dragon immediately thought he would stop an enemy missile with his hat, so he's going to be not on the second one. Also took minimal damage on the arm here. CC, 3 mags, 4 vehicles, all killed. And I kind of stayed around a little bit longer to get some fancy hits in for maximum salvage. That means we're gonna complete our hatchet, man. We could also almost build a second one. Let's briefly see. I'm not a fan of the crit modifier. I'm really only looking for damage and stability damage, all that stuff. Like this SM6. And other than that, I wish it would show you if you have one of these in storage. No, I think I'll just take 2 more Shadowhawk parts, because why not? Alright, we got another Hatchetman part. All great, okay. So that's the quick summary of the first mission. I'm going to play the second mission, give you another summary, and then we'll jump into the flashpoint. I'll be right back.
That mech is ready to fight, Commander.
Okay, and here's the second mission. That was a pretty straightforward slaughter. It was the same map and kind of the same escort mission as the first mission of the previous flashpoint, like in the jungle terrain there, same slopes. We fought 3 medium mechs and then 4 light mechs as reinforcements. You see, we barely took any hits. Oh no, a spider jumped behind me. Yeah, so it only shows 6 kills here because the escorted trucks actually stole one of the kills. The bastards. So yeah, we had a Blackjack, Centurion, bunch of Javelins, a Panther, a Spider, and a Wolverine as enemies. Like, I'm not thrilled about any of that, salvage-wise, so yeah, we can use 5 salvage items, but I don't even know. Sure, let's take an M-Laser Plus. And I guess I'm just gonna... just gonna go like that. Actually, kind of tempted. Yeah, screw that Blackjack. Let's take a Centurion part. Okay, got a bunch more parts. Well, that should complete another banter. Which will probably immediately go to storage because we're kind of full.
That mech you wanted is back online.
So yeah, that's sent you to storage. So scrap would give me 224. Okay, now I'm interested. If I were to sell that Panther, okay, I get more of that. All right. Do I sell the Panther right away? Because I think we have. We do have a Panther, right? We don't need 2. You got a battle-ready Panther. I think I'm just gonna immediately sell that thing. Yeah. Bye-bye. Okay, so now I will fly over here to the next flashpoint, which is gonna take 14 days. Let me just see here what our current state of things is. We are working on the second Griffin and the Wolverine, which is gonna take us 19 days, but I also think I might go through all the mechs that we currently have. I definitely wanna suit up the Hatchet Man. And I think I wanna just look at the mechs and like replace some of the basic SRMs with SRM plus or the LRMs. I think we have picked up a bunch of plus and plus plus weapon upgrades, and we can just make everything just a little bit better. So we're gonna do that on the travel there, and I'll do that off camera, and in a second we'll be at the next flashpoint. See you in a second. Alright, here we go. We are in Klovstand, Tournament of Champions. Short engagement length. Well, let's see what this is all about. And get that 1 million ducats here. High orbit in Klovstand. Always in high orbit. Have you ever seen low orbit there on this thing? Professor Mencius Horvat. Ah, Commander Arva. Very good. I was hoping that you'd accept my invitation. I'm Professor Mencius Horvat, and you are to be congratulated. Only the most celebrated of mercenary companies are allowed to participate in my Tournament of Champions. Yeah, thanks. Well, I always stand to gain by winning this thing. I want to know what he's wearing. That's a seriously bold look, Professor. I don't even know what I'm seeing here. Is you barely see the hat. What you're seeing, Mr. Virtanen, is the hide of a Black Reaper, a savage beast, the apex predator of Jan's One, and a killer of men. Put an end to this one myself. Tracked it for days, stalked it, and lensed it through the heart with a single thrust. Sure. The hide is thick as rubber, yet soft as a lover's charism. Gee, what is that guy real? The forest is luxuriant as it is flagrant. Indeed, this coat is absolutely pregnant with the beast's indelible musk. Who talks that way? I'm overjoyed that we are speaking to you in person. Now let's get back to the press purse. How big is it? 1 million, it said so on the invite. When I take all, of course that means that there will be no intermediate payouts. Eliminated competitors will walk away with nothing. Assume they walk away at all. Arena combat is rich with peril. It can easily swallow the unwary. Yeah, sure. So you say, for now, we'll see if you sing a different tune when you're scraping a prized mech warrior out of a ruined cockpit. Red Death and the arena floor are constant companions. I'd like some of what he has been smoking. But if you speak truly, if you are a hunter of men, you will find much to love in my tournament. For those bold enough to follow our rarefied path, risk it what gives life its flavor, its succulence. Do you salivate at the thought of victory, Commander? Does the prospect of taking all corners, comers and breaking them make your heart hammer in your chest? Yeah, I like the money, actually. Spoken like a true mercenary. If profit is what drives you, I won't ask you to pretend otherwise. Indeed, I encourage you to look onto your opponents as speed bumps on the road to prosperity. Pave them flat and claim the reward that is your due. What are the rules of this journey of yours? The drop weight restrictions, tonnage requirements. Tournament of Champions don't need for such guidelines. In fact, your battle mechs won't be required at all. What? To ensure a level playing field, I insist that all competitors pilot hardware drawn from my own stable, stock mechs, bereft of embellishment or modification. And what if you prefer to use our own mechs? Then you'll be disappointed, I'm afraid, that this rule is inviolable. Should you attempt to deploy your own battle mechs while the tournament is in session, your lives will be forfeit. My enforcer, the man monster Calamar Gigante, will tear you apart. Man monster, wow. No, not at all. Like, Kalahmar Gigante. It's like, okay. I'm just thinking of giant calamaras or something. So long as you honor my master's rules, you have nothing to fear from me. But if you step out of line, I'll wrap you in my terrible grasp and squeeze the life from your chest. I won't stop until I've ground your bones to mulch, for that is the crushing power of Kalahmar Gigante. What are these people? I think there must be some psychedelic plant growing on that planet here. Anyway, isn't it exhilarating? I once saw you enter to strangle a man and his horse at the same time. With his battle mag, which is not a challenge at all. Enough talk. You know the stakes and you understand the risk. Now it's time to make a decision. Accept my contract. I'll test your macroyas in a crucible of blood and thunder. Join us if you dare. Tournament awaits. Anyway, let's get the impression that the professor had a romantic interest in his code. Doesn't just you, but if his content is legit, we stand to win a lot of money, and because of our investing on supplying the hardware, we won't even have to put our own mechs in the line. Who cares if our host is a little eccentric? Exactly. Bunch of nutjobs on this planet. Let's do the mission and then get away from here. Oh, it's generating random missions. Okay, just having a quick look. I might be tempted to do these later on. I'm not gonna do two skull contracts. He says, while accepting the Tournament of Champions, which is a two skull contract, reward nothing, salvage nothing. That's okay, cool. So we have an urban mech, and we can pilot an urban mech. I think to make things more interesting, I'm gonna set myself into an urban mech. Okay then. Can I even have a look at these? Which variant of the urban mech it is? R60. Well, that's certainly going to be, I assume people will not have much evasion in this one. The urban mech, or as fans call it, the walking trash can. It's a 30-ton, I think the stock configuration is just really slow and has an AC-10 or something like that. Objective, win the first round, okay. Question is, it's basically a walking dustbin with a mounted AC-10. That autocannon packs a hell of a punch, but it's only got 8 shots. Keep an eye on those armor counters. But if all the enemies are also only urban mechs, then don't think we need more than 8 shots. Total. And kinda depends on what kind of terrain we have here. If it's really like the tournament arena of the final mission of the story campaign, which I kind of assume it will be. No, initiated. I mean, it's an urban mech. Why wouldn't we fight in the middle of the city with all cars on the streets? Mech warriors, you stand alone in the carcass of an abandoned city. There are cars here. That doesn't look abandoned. Lights are still on. It's a picture. Of commerce is now reborn as a hunting ground in the field of battle, all at the command of my master. Jesus. You honor me and I'm pleased to our guests. I bid you welcome. Ready yourselves and test your might in my tournament of champions. So face off against four of the deadliest killers in the Rimworld, Rimworld periphery. Yes, Dover. To these terrorists, and before you know, the rest look in the shadows. Ooh, like predators on the hunt. Waiting for an exposed thing or bad fruit. They'll eat you alive. They won't get the chance. I will butcher these amateurs before your lurking predators even show their faces. I'm the terror from the Scourge of Sacramonte. I'm limping. Yeah, you will be. And I'm his brother Jake. Yeah, of course Darius likes that B-movie conversation here. Devil is end. Battle-hardened mercenaries at the ever of deadly lone wolves. Let the ground thunder with your approach. Let the tournament begin. Holy hell. Okay, he said two of them are already out here. But then they are not actually. At least I can jump. So all is good. It's not just an AC, I also have a small laser.
Coordinates received.
I copy.
I mean, that's the question is, does the enemy also only have urban mechs? I kind of assumed that, like, he said something about an even playing field.
Waiting for orders.
Move order received.
Location confirmed.
Ugh, 30-ton mechs. Hmm, I wonder what that might be.
Heading out.
Your attention, please. We have a latecomer en route to join our tournament. Consider her a wildcard, if you will. When a drop pod hits the ground, I expect that she'll attempt to butcher the lot of you. Advise you to deny her the opportunity. Kill her before she kills you. Whoa.
They've blown past my armor.
I had 5 pips of evasion, that's not fair. Yeah, let's just reserve and wait for that second dude to also show up. More like it. Okay, of course these guys here
ready for orders.
Cannot get any kind of shots. No? Okay.
Affirmative.
What's up, boss? Roger.
Ooh, what's the right arm, right?
Receiving you.
Okay, so I'm hit on the left side where there's really nothing. Oh no, the small laser. I'm still. I'd prefer you not hitting that side again.
Location confirmed. Got it. Scored a critical hit.
I was a little bit lucky that both AC-10s hit the right arm and destroyed his. His AC-10, yeah. I was just double checking that it actually is located in that arm.
Full throttle.
Heads up, Commander, that dropper must belong to the wildcard contestant that he warned us about. Very perceptive. Got this young lady snooping around the tournament grounds. She claims that I'm responsible for the death of her father. You're responsible, you son of a bitch. By my hand, he will be avenged. I admire your grit, Miss Jones. But if you want a shot at me, you'll need to fight your way out of the arena first. Kill or be killed, let the games continue. I mean, as long as she also only does get an urban mech, I'm fine. Alright, I think I'm gonna...
Commander?
Also, considering waiting for that guy to act, but you know... At least here, yeah, I'll take a shot.
I copy.
Good hit. Someone was shooting something there in the background.
What's up, boss?
Okay. I don't think heat is going to be a problem on these things, so I'm okay with jumping a bit more to get a little bit of evasion here at least.
What's up, boss?
Yeah, okay, I slowly can see how the whole ammo situation can be a bit, you know, limiting. I'm fairly certain I saw like a tile I could jump to. No. Alright, you know what? Just come in here. Part of me thinks I should focus on that guy, but you know, let's just take this one out here. Deal, it's just the site with the ammo. Okay, something is happening over there. I guess the other two, the predators lying in wait, are kind of attacking that lady reinforcement. Well, yeah, that's exactly what I wanted to hit from the back. At least that comet seems to be far away.
Need something, Chief?
I don't think I can actually get properly behind that guy here. Which leg is it? His left leg. Great, I can only get to the right side. So maybe...
Good to go.
Maybe someone here can get to the left. To the left. Nope.
Copy that. Receiving you.
Now, this guy has no arms left, but he can still kick someone, and that would be kind of annoying. So I'm thinking I might just go for the kill here.
Firing on target.
Good to go.
Hopefully going for the kill here.
Hostile eliminated.
I'm gonna need a... I'm losing weapon system.
Yes. That was unfortunate, but it was just the left, right? Okay, some arm went flying over there. That camera work is amazing. I can see how they can get a lot of viewers online.
I'm ready for orders.
It's fine. It's just the small laser. I'm wondering if we should just try to bully that guy. Yes. Let's save a little bit on that ammo. We missed that. Totally missed that.
Yeah, Commander. Lockdown for physical attack.
You also missed? What's happening here?
Failed to connect.
Ready for orders.
I won't miss with three people in a row, right? That didn't look amazing.
Yes, Commander. Moving to position.
Either way, let's make sure that we act before he can act next turn. And let's also destroy his head.
Target's taken a critical hit. Commander?
Keep punching him. Oh, take his lunch money.
Engaging physical attack.
These attacks kind of look underwhelming, don't they?
Standing by. Location confirmed. Engaging. Solid connection on that one.
Hey there.
Okay, just kind of need to make sure that we actually kill him now, right? I mean, unless we kick the one uninjured leg. He should be dead. What are the odds of that happening?
Acknowledged.
Let the people of Flong sleep easy. The brothers Saito are dead. Incapacitated.
Tango down.
It's go time.
Okay. Alexa.
Just waiting for orders.
Let's see what you can do here. Yeah.
Enemy detected.
Oh look, 30-ton mag. And a 30-ton mag. And there's a 30-ton mag there. There's my surprised face. I mean, they're certainly remodeling the city.
Standing by.
Waiting for orders.
Orders? Full speed? No target. Orders?
Alright. Enemy turn, yeah. Maybe I should just... Actually, since Alexa Jones was acting in phase 3 last turn, her Master Mien she was knocked down at some point, so I think she's almost done. Let's still reserve. Okay, also punch. And a miss, and then that other guy coming in. And he's just... He might be, investing into the
Commander.
Real estate here. And just trying to take down some buildings. Behold, Commander Ava, the stalking predators reveal themselves. Now they've been not stalking for a while now. Basilisk Jackson. Like I said, that's the most boring name you could come up with. Basilisk Jackson. You got that right. Basilisk Jackson. I'm one of the meanest. I'm the meanest MacJock, not one of the. On this or any other planet. Gonna put the fools in the ground. Unintelligible whispering. Quaking my boots. Like, I'm not even sure if he's being sarcastic here, like I would be in this situation. I think he's actually, like, shitting his pants right now. Anyway, so, you kinda... Well, you are basically dead. I can't see that guy. Now, I'm still thinking we should then rather shoot the fresh guys. Like, Alexa is not a threat at the moment. So let's shoot those guys that are.
On my way. Engaging target.
That is a miss.
That's a miss.
Yes, Commander. On the move. Affirmative.
Well, that's another AC-10 out of the fight.
Score. Critical hit.
And you can't even get there in time. All right. Charge ahead.
Full throttle.
Nice. Nice jump. Alright, so Basilisk jumped here. And I think Alexa melee attacked that guy. Whispers.
Standing by.
Why don't we get some high ground here? And I'm actually not sure. Maybe we should shoot Whispers, because that's the most dangerous mech right now. Maybe we should even precision shoot Whispers in that drawer where the ammo is.
Engaging. Inflicted some heavy damage.
Okay, at this point, it's a bunch of small lasers and melee attacks.
All weapons committed. Enemy mech destroyed.
The most dangerous mech jog on any planet.
Yes, Commander.
Just went down.
Affirmative.
I think it's just a mercy shot at this point.
Taking this.
My master would be assassin has fallen, but still she lives. Her ejection pod has saved her, but for how long?
Standing by. Coordinates received.
Hi.
Feel the love.
So I'm thinking we probably we're done soon, right? So we don't need to worry about ammo or anything here. Just kill that guy.
Enemy mech, critical damage detected.
Ready for orders. Target acquired.
I think that was
negative damage. Repeat, negative damage. Orders?
Can you hit from up here? Yes, you can. You could.
Failed. Connect.
Let's just skip you.
How's it going?
I really Roger don't that. Want that guy to do like a death from above attack or anything here, so let's just take a...
I copy.
Take a precision shot to make sure that we can act before he can act again. Okay.
What's up, boss?
That 90% shot. Can you do that again?
Receiving you.
Last shot.
Target confirmed.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
No joy. All out of AC-10 ammo.
Affirmative.
There you go. Behold, Professor Basilisk Jackson and his silent partner down the Belmech's shattered. Their bodies torn to bloody wrecks. It's glorious. Display fit for a king. Well done, Commander. Very well done indeed. You have taken this round and vanquished your foes. I haven't tapped out yet, Howard. You'll never hear me yield. You don't need to yield. You've lost. And you'll be spending the remainder of this tournament in a holding cell. Thank you, Egant. To these drones, victors, I invite you to bask in your triumph, but prepare yourselves. Tomorrow, you face the ultimate challenge. Tomorrow, your true test begins.
Mission successful.
So, in the mission briefing for this flashpoint, there was something about consecutive deployments, and it said no. But it certainly seems like we'll have another fight immediately afterwards, with no time to rest here. So no smiley. Oh, we actually get salvage. That's great. I guess we got ourselves another mech. I wonder if the second part of the tournament is also just going to be urban mechs.
That mech you wanted is back online.
Yeah, that mech I wanted is immediately going to storage. Tournament of Champions, part 2. High orbit, curve stand. Yeah, I think we can do the second part as well here. So far so good, I think that we could win this tournament. This whole tournament is positively mental. Howard and his cronies are throwing up more red flags than a Croatian military, right? And you're preaching to the choir, right? You're looking at how ridiculous this is. Yes. I think that's the first time I agree with her. Howard's a lunatic, and our fellow competitors aren't much better. Speak of the devil, we're getting a security call from inside Howard's castle. It's Jackhammer, you remember? The I'm here to avenge my father lady. I'm surprised they don't have access to the comm system. You need to keep this brief. Forward's catching me talking about his subdermal mic. He'll probably put a spear through my chest. Is this about your father? My father is alive and well on Leamington. That whole vengeance stick is just a cover story. The truth is, I'm an undercover operative with the MIIO, Ministry of Infirmary Intelligence and Operations. The Federated Suns, okay. And I'm here to investigate his crimes against Davian commercial interests. He's a pirate, in case you hadn't figured that out. So you should be doing the whole har. Shiva me timbers. He also wants to marry his Fokovit. Why do we care? This tournament is a sham. The whole circus is a sick joke that he uses to sniff out highly skilled, morally flexible mech warriors. He has strength and wants to surround himself with it, but his standards are impossibly high. A second round in the tournament is a trap. If you're good enough to push through and win anyway, the professor will shower you in blood money to buy your friendship. If he finds you wanting, he'll kill you for sport. Will you use a spear? He uses whatever he damn well pleases. He's a pirate. He doesn't play by anyone's rules, especially not his own. The professor has been running this contest for years, and in all that time, the only actual winner has been Calamar Gigante. Everyone else, we're talking hundreds of contestants here, has mysteriously disappeared, and if you let your mech warriors compete again, he'll make them disappear too. So our options aren't that great, huh? They really, really aren't, but fortunately for you, I'm here. I've been authorized to offer you an alternative. Stavian has granted me the authority to draft a kill order for Professor Howard, like your company, to carry out the contract. Is that already a final decision here? I don't know. Hey, you remember when she said she's gonna keep it short because she doesn't want to be detected? Yeah, that was like 15 minutes ago. Okay, details. Break the rules of a tournament. Instead of piloting a couple of busted old Urbies, you drop your heaviest lens right on Howard's head. When the kill has been confirmed, I'll transfer 250,000 C-bills into your account. Yards of the thanks of the Federated Suns. But that feels like a lot less than the actual million that Horvath's offering. That doesn't keep our company in the back. You don't get the prize purse unless you win, and you won't win. That's what I've been telling you. He'll cheat, and he'll kill your Macquarius, and you'll walk away with nothing. Even if you do somehow manage to beat him, you won't like what happens next. He'll pay you, sure. But cozying up to Horvath will land you on the shit list of every pirate-hating client in the galaxy. That means everyone, the successor states, the perfume powers, you name it. Nobody likes a pirate. That's not true. Pirates are fun. I've made you a fair offer, Commander. For the good of every Davian merchant in the remote periphery, I need you. I need to take Mitchell's over down. I don't know when we're going to get another opportunity like this. Okay. Attempt to win, beat him as his own game. So, playing regularly. Or, accept the special contract here. Once again, let's believe James Bond here and take the MI6 contract. Good choice. I take the fear and join you, but something tells me I'm stuck in this cage until the fight is over. Do me a favor and win this thing. Okay, so we're just gonna bring our good old Thunderbolt, Griffin, Shadowhawk, Centurion. And wreck some face. Now, I assume that we'll probably not just be fighting Urban Max. Or we have to fight some Urban Max and then Gigante Calamaris will spawn and try to stop us. The whole briefing without saying the hunter will become the hunted. I'm pleasantly surprised. Yeah. It's kinda would have been needed to complete the cliche here. Alright, here we go.
Command interface initiated.
So, you have elected to violate the rules of my tournament. You've decided to kill me, perhaps? To take on the great hunter in his den? Is that like a hologram of a walking mech? That's cute. Something like that. Like, how is everybody in my company always on the microphone? Don't they have things to do? What a welcome diversion this is. Truly glorious. I had intended to challenge you, Macquarius, when the tournament was finished, as is my custom, to put them to the final test. Instead, you've provided me with full lens of quarry to hunt down and slaughter. We'll enjoy this, won't we, Gigante?
Command interface initiated.
Yeah, sure. And in the arena, I'll personally rend these overconfident fools limb from quivering limb. There you have it, Commander. Something to look forward to. Between now and then, I present you with the remaining contestants of Tournament of Champions. I'm sure they'll keep you occupied until our drop pods arrive. Yeah, I don't think they will.
Position confirmed.
Hey.
Okay, let's sneak you around the backside.
Okay, let's go.
Oh look, an unknown mech. I wonder what that is.
Confirmed.
Holding a gun to the Raptors have almost reached the AO. We just started. Still remodeling the city, yeah?
What now?
Think you can come over here? And then have a little discussion with this little Abby.
There. Okay.
Why he doesn't wanna
copy that.
Continue this fight.
Firing Alpha Strike. But that hurt. Hey there.
Okay, I kinda wanna have some eyes on the other guy.
On my way.
Oh look, it's an urban mech. So I'm thinking we're gonna multi-target here, because I want to get a little bit of damage in on that guy on the left here. Something like this.
What's up, boss?
And same thing here.
Multiple targets confirmed.
Okay, can we at least take down one of the urban mechs before the actual combat happens here? Not. Yeah, that looked like four drop pods there, not just Gigante and I. So what's in there? This was like the most menacing view of an urban mech ever. Got another urban mech shooting an urban mech from that side, and another, yeah. Okay. He's in a blackjack, how cute. And Gigante is in a centurion. Didn't he say he's gonna be the enforcer?
Okay. Waiting for order.
Never mind. How about I jump behind you?
Roger.
All your own. And we're just gonna hammer that blackjack. Doesn't the blackjack have the AC ammo in the center torso? Isn't that a really bad design?
Affirmative.
Hey, he didn't do anything. Come on, at least fight back.
Standing by.
Gonna do a little bit of a hiding here.
Reporting critical hit.
I'm here.
A little bit more aggressive, I can get 70, but then I'm kind of in short range of everybody. I have a lot of evasion. I'm sure that's not gonna be dangerous in any kind of way. Mr. Bossman here. See how you like that.
Enemy mech destroyed.
Okay. That's one urban mech fighting another urban mech. One of the contestants going for one of the Harvard guys. Or the other way around. Did you just headbutt me?
You can cut it out now.
Yeah, I was going to say the same thing. Head destroyed. Did he just... I think he death from above that? Just crazy people here all around. So really the only one still moving this turn is the Centurion. And I'm just gonna take a good shot at this guy here.
Oh, yeah.
Solid connection on that one.
He just stays stationary and shoots me. Right, so far, the enemies have been acting really dumb. Like, incredibly dumb.
On my way.
Almost as dumb as the dialogue so far.
Heck no. Score. Critical hit. Standing by.
He's dying.
Firing up
straight. Thank you.
Enemy down.
Leaves us with little Mr. Centurion with his exploded ammo. And that urban on the rooftop there. You know what? Let's just go for the Centurion. Yeah, okay, so his initiative is ruined next turn. Like, that head should almost be gone. There's one hit point left on that head. AC-10 is really an unthankful weapon. It's doing 60 damage, and heads always have 61.
Yes, Commander.
Alright, so I think I'm just gonna...
I'll try.
Go and punch this guy.
Going hand to hand, I guess. Critical hit, Commander.
Need something, Chief?
And how about we do the same thing over here?
Roger. On it. Target's taking a critical hit.
Receiving you. On the move.
Something like this. Didn't do much. Okay. I'm sure we'll figure something out to kill all of them. A, B, C. Let's go 3 lasers on A. These two on B. No, actually, this on B and this on C.
Multiple targets.
It's not quite a kill. That is a kill. So I'm hoping for the head hit. So
waiting for
that's
order.
What we're gonna do. Gonna precision strike you to the hat. Just with the LM10. Not good enough.
Bye.
Just wondering if we can somehow like get the salvage.
Right here. If you say so.
Yeah. What's up, boss?
Okay, so maybe we can destroy that leg here. Make him fall down again.
Let's do this.
Oh, you know, that works too.
Got it.
And then it's just a matter of wiping this thing off the planet.
Engaging physical attack.
You've done well, Commander. There's a small army of Federation freight captains out there who'll sweep a whole lot of easier. Sleep a whole lot of easier tonight. Well, it's a pleasure to work for the MIIO. Seeing of which, I believe that you owe us a substantial amount of money. Yes, ma'am, I do. And as soon as the MIIO finishes spraying me from this prison cell, I'll be happy to settle up.
Mission successful.
Curious now how much reputation that actually gives us with the Federated Sons. 6 reputation. Oh boy. We're like almost maxed out on reputation, not so much at once. Also I didn't see the 250k. At least we can get some Centurion salvage. Now, I'm really curious what the other decision would have been if we had gone for the mission. Oh, Tournament Champion 3. Well done, Commander. Well done, indeed. I've sent a wire to Lady Cunningham informing her of your assistance and requesting a 250,000 Seabills. Can expect your payments directly. What's next for you, Agent Jones? Got another pirate organization to bust up? Eventually, I've got about a month's worth of paperwork to submit before I can get back out in the field. Howard has been hijacking defensive shipments for years, stockpiling battle mechs that were intended for the defense of House Levian's outer colonies. You should see his armory, it's like an urban mech graveyard in there. Must be a beautiful sight. Man, but I love these ridiculous little machines. Tell you what, I'm technically overstepping my authority by doing this, but I'm gonna authorize the transfer of some of those Irby's parts to your armory, for your dropship. Do me a solid, and it's unlikely that they'll be missed. Yeah, curb your enthusiasm. Yeah, it's like urban mechs. Gonna turn around and sell them. No, excuse me, I need to go. Gotta get back to the tournament site before anyone notices that jackhammer is gone. This is a special day for her, after all. Her father has finally been avenged. This did not turn out so bad. We got out of the tournament in one piece, gained some clout with our stadium, and got a nice chunk of Irby for trouble. Could have gone a whole lot worse. We all knew that Howard was a little off when we decided to enter the tournament. No notable salt in the wound. Let's prep for Argo travel. Getting out of here. Bonus rewards. Ah, we got one urban mech part. Great. We got a dragon part. Alright. And a sweet large laser. It's not so bad. Medium laser, okay. And the 250. Oh, and here we get another 12 reputation. Now we're talking. Well, that was the Tournament of Champions. With a big plot twist there. Let's take a quick look here. So the next. Hang on, so I was aware of this flashpoint, which has the light tonnage requirement, so we can probably only drop 250 tons. Double agent. Alright, we still have the flat earthers here. It's going away in 67 days, so that might be a 3.5 difficulty. And then we have this one for the Kellhounds. That's one like a famous mercenary company. For some rare items. Let me actually see that again here. So this is 170. This one all the way over, 150. And this one is actually going pretty soon, 67 days, and we're gonna travel 20. So I'm actually thinking, okay, that's also 3.5. So I'm gonna do the 2.5 skull missions on this planet where we're at. Off camera again. Then it's a question of whether we make a pit stop like here in Renown, do a mission onto there. It's a 2.5 skull system, so we're probably gonna find some nice free skull contracts. And yeah, with that additional equipment, we can then tackle this one here. Flattened Earth. The Razorbacks are the opposition, okay. We'll have consecutive deployments. Medium length, so I'm assuming medium is like 3 missions in a row. So yeah, again, as I said, longer episodes today. So the contracts that are here, I don't think they are really make for interesting watching. So I'm gonna do the 2.5 skull contracts off camera. I'm not sure if I'll show you the results each time, because that's really just the difference between playing with recording setup in place or just playing with loud music in the background. Yeah. Don't think that I'll do any of the 2 skulls. I don't know, maybe a battle or something. That's a nice salvage, but 2 skulls is just gonna be a bunch of light mechs, right? I'll think about it. Either way, we'll probably, when we come back here, we're gonna be in the Renown system. That's over here. And then see what's available there. And worst case, we find nothing and just continue on to the next flashpoint. Alright, until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.